first, very much in the touching of Father's shoulder. You want to hear the account of the Anderson fire. Saw deer, saw buck, shot the buck, missed the buck. This is not good, the Anderson clan. I will have to live with this for at least a year, unless I get one later this evening. Did you get yours, Paul? I feel bad. What's, you knew this question was coming. What's Father's word of the month? Very good. Very good. And just so we don't have to struggle next month, the word for December is generosity. Friendship, it's defined as kindness or help given to someone. Friendship, you are born into your family, that was God's choice. You get to choose your friends, that's your choice. But what does the talents theme in today's gospel have to do with friendship? The answer is everything. In true friendship, we are willing to do things for our friends that sometimes we wouldn't even do for our own families. That simply translates that we are willing to share our talents for the betterment of our friends. Our parish community is no different than the general population that we swim in every day. As an assembly of Christian Catholics, we are considered a family. Remember, if you don't get to choose family, that's God's choice. However, for most of us, we have chosen friends from this faith community. The difference here is that our friendships share the core beliefs of the church. Additionally, there is the gift of the Holy Spirit that glues these friendships together. As a result, the talents we share with our church friends automatically have a higher purpose: advancing the soul to heaven, helping a brother or sister in Christ to their journey to sainthood. This is why it's so important to use your talents that God has given each and every one of us for the church. Not using your talents that God has given you is the opposite of friendship and love. It is using our talents that we become more self, more friendly, more human, more imitating Christ. You've heard someone say, that person is very talented. In reality, what that person is saying is, that person has chosen to share their talent. And with that, it is implied more than most people are willing to share their talent. As baptized Christians, we have a moral obligation to share our talents. God did not give us the gift of us with the intention of burying ourselves in the ground until the day we die, only to return the gift of us with the original talent. God expects a return on his talent he has so graciously given each and every one of us. God put the gift of you and me here to benefit each other, to be the hands and feet of Christ. And if we are the hands and feet of Christ, we can't bury our talents in the ground any more than the stone tomb could bury Christ. Be a friend. Share your talents. Be more fully human. Be more fully Christian. Then, after we have completed our race here on earth, sharing our talents, we will hear, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Come share your master's joy." Now, that was going to be my end, but I had my wife to treat my mommy, as she graciously does with many of them. And she said, "Greg, not real personal." So we're going to get personal. My best friend, Chuck, just lost his life. We've been texting back and forth. He said to me, "Greg, you always have my back." And I always do. And I always will. That's what friendship is about. But I wasn't doing anything great. I was just imitating my friend and our pastor, Father Peter, because he always has